Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabid here. And today we're going to be looking at the EPYC 7742 on Dero. We're going to see what kind of hash rates and power consumptions we can get out of this thing. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the EPYC 7742, this is a server grade processor from AMD. It's got 64 cores, 128 threads, and 256 megabytes of L3 cache. Now, the L3 cache, I don't think really matters for Dero, but you know, we'll have to find out on some smaller CPU for that kind of play out. But the big thing here that I'm excited about is how is RAM going to affect Dero. So in this rig, I do have 8 sticks of 2666 megahertz RAM. And it's not the fastest. You can get up to 32 megahertz for this. But when it came to Dero with the 3000 and 5000 series, as well as the 7000 series test, RAM did not matter. If I was running dual channel with 2 sticks or single channel with 1 stick, we would get the same hash rate. Now, OCTOMINER, it does have a mem tweak, so we'll try that out as well. But the big thing here I am curious about, will 8 sticks versus 1 stick actually matter? So we're gonna have 8 channel of RAM here with all the sticks in, and then with only 1 stick we're gonna have single channel. Now, if we still have the same hash rates, I won't even measure in between, but if we do see a big gap in performance, I will then try dual channel and quad channel underneath of the 8 channel memory. So we'll see what happens initially, but we're gonna start off with 8 channels here, and then I'm just gonna move it straight to 1 stick and see what that hash rate looks like, and we'll kind of base the rest of the video based on that. So before we begin our first test here, I do wanna point out that it looks like OCTOMINER did release an update recently, so you may be noticing maybe a large hash rate spike. So we don't know yet how well this is gonna perform versus other ones until we check everything out. But right now we can see there's version 1.9.2.R5. And basing on last week, there was another one, exact same version number here, but R4, they increased the hash rate by 2 to 2.5%, and then followed up with a fine tuning engine 3 with the parameter -FT3. So I'll try this out as well as the OPTIMEM to see how they perform and whatnot, as well with those sticks there. But just to know that I did update the current hash rates on the 3900X, 3950, 5950X, and 7950X, because those are the only ones I have. So a 3900X is now doing 15,320 hashes. I do need to redo all my 3900X tests here because I don't know the power consumptions with all these latest miners I have released. So I plan on testing all these CPUs again here in the future. But right now we're up to 15.3 kilohash on a 3900X. 3950 is up to 20.5 kilohash. 7950X is up to 28 kilohash, and then we got the 5950X is up to 19.5 kilohash. So this is all in the default parameters now for these CPUs, just so you guys know that there is more hash rate with the latest miner version that's currently released. And if you are looking to mine Dero on a pool, check out the Rabid Pool. I have the Stratum link down in the description. Come hang out with us and mine some Dero. All right, so we are downloading the latest miner. We do see using fine tune engine 3, and inside the flight sheet itself, I do not have that in there. So I got rid of all my extra config arguments, so I must just run it by default at this point, and I'm not using any type of opmem test. And for hash rates, it's currently looking like, we're gonna give it a few minutes here, but we're at 59.43 kilohash, 59.4. We'll wait for one more ticker here, but we're looking like about 59 point something on the hash rate. Now the power consumption is looking like about 280 watts or so. All right, so now I'm running the miner with the opmem command here. We're gonna come into our flight sheet and then into our miner itself. And it looks like we are seeing an increase in hash rate at anywhere from 60.4 to a little over 61 kilohash. So it's definitely doing something for the hash rate here. Do a refresh, 61.5. Now at the wall, our power is about 270 watts. So we actually gained hash rate and lost like 10 watts at the power using the opmem command, which is very interesting and makes me definitely need to retest all the 3 and 5000 series CPUs. All right, so I went from 8 sticks straight down to 1 stick, and we'll definitely know if RAM does affect this thing or not, as well as channels when it comes with the EPYCs on Dero. As for the 3 and 5000 series, it did not matter. So I am in C1. If you saw my XMR hash rate test, you know exactly how all these slots work out. So let's jump into the workstation now and see if 1 stick of RAM will just make us do the same hash rate and a lot more efficient, or we may lose all our hash rate. All right, guys, so 1 stick of RAM, we are still at 59.61 kilohash. Actually, we just refreshed to 59.74. We're about 264 watts at the wall, which is crazy. We dropped almost 20 watts here from removing all that RAM sticks, but we did not lose any hash rate, which is kind of what I was expecting for the algorithm based on what our testing was way on before with the 3 and 5000 series. So Random X and I believe YesScript R16, which I haven't tested yet on this. Well, when it comes to RAM dependent algorithms, it definitely matters. But ones like Dero, and hopefully we'll find out when we test Viruscoin as well as Ghost Rider, that on the 3 and 5000 series, it didn't seem like RAM mattered. And a single stick of RAM, even in this EPYC at single channel, is still producing the same hash rate as 8 sticks of RAM and running 8 channels. So that's crazy. So now we got to move in and kind of check out if that memory optimization does anything with that single stick. All right, so I did add in that opmem option here, and it's looking like we're doing about 61.52 kilohash, 61.62, and at the wall we're about 260 watts. So we did lose a little bit of power again utilizing opmem, but it almost seems like with a single stick we're getting more performance than with the 8 sticks. It's not by much, but we're getting at least the same amount of hash rate and actually a slight bit more. So this is very interesting findings when it comes to the Dero Astrobot V3 algorithm. All right, guys, so now let's kind of look at the spreadsheet and have a look at everything. And as you can see here, RAM dependent, like Random X, was pretty much the opposite of what we're finding out on Dero, where 8 sticks is actually our least efficient setting here at 211.423 hashes per watt of power used, and only 1 stick with opmem is our actual best one at 236.846 hashes to watt. So just like we saw with 3 and 5000 series CPUs, a single stick of RAM is all that is needed for Dero versus all 8 channels and 8 sticks. Dero is not memory dependent like Monero is with the Random X algorithm, and this opens up a whole new floodgates on building the proper rig depending on the coin. Now when I build rigs, I do optimize for every algorithm, which means it does cost a little more for something because I am optimizing for Random X, and then everything else I can just pull sticks out and stuff and run at reduction of power depending on the profitability of whatever coin is on.
All right, guys, so there we have it. This CPU is performing as predicted based on the RAM on Dero and the algorithm that Dero runs on. Now, I wasn't 100% sure due to the fact that this does use 8-channel RAM and it's a server grade and so on, but it looks like the laws of the algorithm are unaffected by the CPU. We're still seeing, just like the 3 and 5000 series, that RAM does not matter when it comes to Dero, which does add to that cheaper rig build cost and so on. But very interesting here, Random X, it definitely did have an effect, but here we're not seeing it. So it's going to be interesting when we do try Ghost Rider, when we do try Viruscoin and all these other algorithms that we still have to test. But so far it is looking like the algorithms, they still play out the same way they did with those 3 and 5000 series and RAM dependent versus RAM dependent algorithms. So thank you for checking out this video, guys. This video was pretty awesome to dictate what's going on here. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.